Hello, everybody. I am Leary Lee. Oh, shoot. Okay. We loaded everything up. I am really sorry. I am already a registered nurse, but I am in nurse practitioner school, and I had a really big test, and I had not really studied for it, and I had to study instead of recording Hiveswap on Tuesday, so real sorry about that, but we're going to finish it up tonight. This is Thursday, but I just have like a random brick of time, so we're going to try to get us all finished up with this game, and that'll leave us free to start something new next Tuesday. Okay, if you remember, we are Joey Claire, I believe is her last name. We are still running from the Lucis. We got all hive swappered out, and this is Damic Tetrarch or something like that. This is his house, and we've been talking to his friend Zephros using the tablet. You have a little brother at home called Jude. He sent us a pigeon with marbles. You remember, now you can use the pigeon on everything, which I find kind of hilarious, but I won't make you guys sit through all of that. So, all right, let's get back to it. I believe this game... Oh, hey, the tablet's doing the thing again. All right. I just ran into a wall. Let's pretend that didn't happen. Hey, Xerox, you there? Oh, clicks right. Can't really go anywhere else with the that was Jude's voice. What did I have for his voice? Can't really go anywhere else with the debris slowly crushing my body. Oof, right, sorry. It's okay. It doesn't sound okay. Try not to move too much. Okay, I'll try. I'm going to pass out a little now. Wait, real quick. I'm having trouble with the security puzzle. You call it security puzzle. You could call it. I solved the one in the basement, no sweat, but this one seems kind of different. Security puzzle? Do you mean the serpent ROM that Tetrarch Damic rigged up to his power hexagrid? I wouldn't have used those words, but if you think that's what I'm talking about, it probably is. There's another one? A different one? I think so. The start screen is different anyway. And the power is still on, so I don't know what it would be connected to. His hive security, probably. He's always tinkering with it to make it more complex. Yeah, for the one in the basement, I only had to eat the letters. But now, they're different? There's different letters to eat, but I don't know what letters to eat, if that makes sense. Oh, it's probably XXXX. Oh, really? No, wait, sorry, I meant a different number of X's. Yeah, I got it. No, that's not it. What? I'm typing it in, but it keeps getting changed to a bunch of X's. Maybe that's the new software, security software I installed? It must stop me from posting my password to chat. Oh, if only that existed in real life. Really? Let me try. Mrs. Taylor Thomas, 80. Do you guys remember Jonathan Taylor Thomas? He was like the hottie of my generation back in the day. He was on Home Improvement. He did other things too, but that's the only thing I remember right off the top of my head. Can you see that? Mrs. Taylor Thomas, 80? OMG. What's that? No. You told me it would turn it into X symbols. Well, you're using the Tetrarch's tablet. It wouldn't know your password. I can't believe I did that. Sorry, I'm going home. I can never show my face on this planet again. He's confused. Mrs. Taylor Thomas, 80 seems like a nice password. I never guessed that. You must be really smart, Joey. No, I am apparently super stupid. What's so embarrassing about it? Everybody makes mistakes. It's just... Well, I guess it's the name of a boy I like. Really? Haha, but don't tell anyone, but that's my password. That's what my password is, too. Aw. Do you have a girl you like? No, it's... Oh, no, it's a boy. Oh, for some reason, I thought you were a boy all this time. I am, hee-hee. Oh, huh. So, not trying to rush you or anything, but I'm still dying in rocks about this security console. Yeah, about that. Can you, like, give me a hint? It's the name of our band, but there's a couple different ways to spell it. That's pretty weird. Yeah, we keep going back and forth between this and this. I actually don't know which one is right now. Well, I'll scout around and see if I can find something. He's bound to have it written down somewhere or something, right? I hope so. I'm gonna conserve my strength a little bit, maybe getting kind of dead. Hang in there. I'll be there as soon as I can. Okay, let's try not to suck. You have to click this, and then you have to do this. It was the grubbles, but I... Which one of those looks more like an R? I guess the bottom one? Nope. So, I know that it's over here. No. There it is. Can I has it? Can I take it with me? That was the one I picked, wasn't it? Then the 2BLY looking thing. Alright, what does this do? Oh. No, that's not what I wanted. Return. Alright. Let's see if we can do it correctly. Go over here, please. Over here. This is the one I picked, I thought. This one? This one? Oop. This one? Oh shoot, both of those kind of look like an L. Okay. Oh, now they have it up in the corner for me. Was it there last time and I just didn't notice it? Probably. So I'm looking for this guy here. And then the, like, upward mountain thing. And then this one. And then two of the bees. Oh! That was dirty. And then this one. And then this one. Huzzah! Okay. that's Seleucus. He's so cute. Why would you be afraid of it? Like, wouldn't you, like, introduce yourself through the door and see if it's... The next time I'm afraid of something, I'm gonna pirouette away from it. Well, figured out the game, but the monster chased me into the, I'm fairly confident this is a kitchen. It's really gross, but anyway, keeping you informed. He's dying still. Monster? Wait, sorry, a little woozy. The deer cat. Oh yeah, now I remember. The Tetrarch's Lucis. Okay, sure. Hey, while we have a second, maybe you can fill me in on what that means? What means? What's a Lucis? Wow. What? It's just about the saddest thing I ever heard get said. But you didn't actually hear it get said, because this is over text. Yeah, cultural differences, etc., etc. Can you bring me up to speed on this wild beast stalking me? Why does Damek even have a crazy cat monster in his house? I have two crazy cat monsters in my house, and they very frequently are on my videos. Well, it's usually not crazy. Your Lucis takes care of you. It protects you from wild monsters and also dying and, like, whatever, you know? I guess mine's not too good at that, since I'm being crushed by heavy debris.
Debris.
Not really. Are they all, beasts? Well, yeah, what else would they be? And they're always this rambunctious? I mean, it seems like it'd be pretty crazy if anyone in your family had their own rip-snorting monster. What's a family? It's some adults and their kids, or one adult and some kids, or maybe some kids and their babysitter, and the conspicuous absence of a father who is garbage. Isn't garbage. Adults! Yeah, why? Adults live on your planet? Yeah, of course. Is that not where they live for you? For your adults? Sorry, this is somehow the weirdest thing you've said yet. Once you come of age, you get sent off planet for your ordeals. And that's it? Nobody ever comes back? Ever? No exceptions. There are no adults on Alternia. I keep going into Jude's voice for some reason. I think this might be another, wow, I'm an alien conversation. Better save for when you're not pinned under a bunch of rocks. Probably. I'm going to have to rest a second. Okay, well, I'm going to focus on finding the hover pad. I'll let you know when I do. Thanks, Joey. I'm going to focus on maintaining consciousness, I think. Good plan. Stay alive, kid power. Oh, geez, that was awful. Sorry, bye. Is this a refrigerator? Cabinet is empty. There's a bowl in the back, a clean bowl. Maybe Damek missed it, too. That would explain why it's actually clean. And then... this is probably a fridge. Open. Can I click on things? Are those teeth? Get. Anything that I can get. Lucis milk. Sweet. Okay. Let's go up here. Oh, that looks what I need. Looks like what I need. Zephyros says this is his, but it looks like Damek has other ideas. Oh well, Damek isn't here. Now you can help Zephyros with it and help Zephyros by it, and help Zephyros by returning it. I found the hover pad. Hover sled? Whatever it's called, I got it. I can come save you. Excellent. Although I think I'm a little boxed in. Between the deer cat and this pile of guns and drums, I don't really have a clear path. Oh well, I'll figure it out. Well, the Tetrarch made some... Excessive modifications to my hover pad. That might be able to help. Yeah. This guy doesn't sound like he has good sense or of respect for personal boundaries. For boundaries or personal property. I can read today. Oh, he hates it. Tetrarch Demix says, the concept of private property is a vehicle for exploitation and the tool by which the high bloods subjugate the low blood underclass. Well, I'm new here, so I really can't comment, I guess. Anyway, it'll be back in your hands now, so problem solved. Yay. Okay, I'll give it a shot. Talk to you soon. Okay, so did we just put it in our pocket? Can I move those? Just plunge your hand into a pile of death, huh? You think you'll look around a bit for something to assist you. Can I use this? That's not how a hoverboard works. I expected it to like hover it. I don't remember it doing that. Also explosions. Fun. If the Tetrax Lucis is upset, it might have gotten hurt. Oh, gotten. That's cute. Anyway, I did see a whole lot of blood smeared up to a huge hole in the floor. Oh no! Well, it was pretty brown, so it's pretty old. Not sure what you mean. Tetrarch has bronze blood. So, that's either Damic or his Lucis, and it's recent. Wait, okay, you've been saying things about blood color a lot, but I've been assuming it was metaphorical. Are you saying that your members of your species literally have different colors of blood? Yeah, I'm a rust blood. Bronze, rust, so it's metals thing? No, it's by color. I'm actually a burgundy blood, but... but maybe this isn't the best time to talk about all this. Yeah, I'll be glad to tell you all about the blood on our planet when I'm not leaking so much of it on the ground. Wow, I really thought I'd be dead by now. Don't worry, I'm coming as soon as I figure out a way past this wild beast. Maybe I can outrun him, maybe I can sneak past him, maybe I can give him a treat. Maybe I can give him a treat. I do have some pet treats. What's a pet? I think it would be a little weird if I described that to you, given the fact that you were, like, it sounds like raised by one. Let's move on. Do we really have to do all of them? Maybe I can sneak past him. Pretty unlikely. Wait, are you the kind of alien that's invisible and silent? No. Yeah, no chance then. Maybe I can outrun him. I'm surprised he's been chasing you. That's really not like him. Well, now that you mention it, he didn't exactly chase me. I think this might be all a misunderstanding. He's probably upset with Damic missing and everything that happened before you got there. I mean, they can be kind of frustrating. Lucises, I mean. They mean well, but... and they try to take care of you, but they don't always know what they're doing. And it's not always easy to understand them, you know? Yeah, I have someone like that. Oh... yeah, my babysitter. You'd love her. Her name has an X in it. I don't remember what she said it was. Alexa or something? Well, okay, if we have an upset beast on our hands, there's really only one thing to do. Yeah? Joey Claire, amateur veterinarian, is going pro. Remember, she wanted to be a veterinarian. BRB. Just think of all the possibilities for alien animal care held in just this little kit. You kind of regretted not taking the one from your bedroom, but this more than makes up for that absurd blunder. Anything else that I'm missing here? Am I supposed to go down there yet? Okay, what am I supposed to do down here? Is it just gonna stare at me? You gotta find some way to distract it so that you can approach from the other side. I remember it's something with the milk in the bowl. Do I put that here? Here? Can you put it?
Can you put it down?
Oop, no. Came from that way. Did I miss any of this stuff? So now I'm back in the kitchen. Can I put it here? Can I? Oh, okay. Here, kitty, kitty. Here, kitty, kitty. Duh. See, it's adorable. Okay, so now you're supposed to go the other direction. No, I don't.
Go up the stairs.
This is why I can't play click to moves for very long at a time. I just end up yelling at the screen. I mean, I do that sometimes with non-click to moves, but it seems to frequently happen more frequently with click to moves. All right, now he's over here. Somewhere. There we go. You need to find some literature on the patient. But where to look? It'd probably be sitting out in a general mess. Up here, maybe? Can I check over here? There looks like there's books over here, but I can't get to them. No, that's not what I want. Maybe it's back in here and I just didn't... Oh. I was gonna say, there's some books over here. You pick up the, let's see, looks like this is the big book of beasts. You flip through, glimpsing tons of monsters at various levels of, I believe that's supposed to be weird, cute, scary, and spectacular. You can also use this to learn more about the weird alien life on this weird alien planet. Neat! Okay, I don't care. Okay, let's go fix our little kitty. Come here. So what do? Do I use the book on him? You pick a page at random and accidentally spend a few minutes reading about a muscle beast pectoral tumescence. Maybe you should just use this on the Lucis that you actually encounter. Also, hope you never encounter that one. But I did use it on him. Let's see here. Oh, here we go. Its scientific name is apparently a cuspidated grimalkin. Ahem. The cuspidated grimalkin is a chimerical union of predator and prey, with the strengths of both long retractable claws and razor-sharp teeth, alongside a defensive crown of stabbing horns. The speed for lightning-quick dashes and the endurance to run an entire night without tiring. Proud and resplendent. I love that word, resplendent. Cuspidated grimalkin prefer to bond with bronze-blood wigglers, in whom they sense a strong natural aptitude for leadership. Such aspiration in low bloods are grounds for culling, of course, and the primary cause of death for cuspidated grimalkin is the defense of their treasonous wards. Anecdotal accounts suggest that those cuspidated grimalkin who manage to survive the death of their wards will typically seek out a similarly orphaned troll and attempt to bond with them, although the selection process is naturally rather mysterious due to its staggering illegality. Several anatomical diagrams are included from these. You think you'll be able to treat the deer cat, which is what you're going to continue calling it for right now. Cuspidated grimalkin is just a bit of a mouthful. Let's use him on there. Buyers may be able to pluck the thorn from the deer cat's paw, and they and then they would be best friends. But maybe they'd start to get closer to each other than you and start to exclude you from things. You've been burned before. Better just pluck the thorn yourself. Because he does indeed have a thorn in his paw. Aww. Poor little guy. Slurps. Look at him. How could she ever be afraid of him? Aw, what a cutie. But what's his name? You could ask Zephyros, you guess. But you feel like there's something between the two of you now. Something that merits a new one. Cornabuster? That's stupid. The other one was Zoo Smell, and I turned it to Zoom. Maybe I'll do Buster. Sounds good to me. And now we get to ride him. Now that I'm thinking about it, I'm suddenly pretty nervous about how I'm going to get over there. I keep seeing shadows of huge, hulking things flying around outside. Yeah, the crossing won't be easy. I'm sorry. Is it always this hard to get across the street? No. I mean, not usually. Things got pretty intense. How do you mean? Somebody was supposed to be meeting... Somebody we were supposed to be meeting up with didn't show. Or maybe they did and it went bad. I really don't know. Damick didn't tell me what was happening. And I screwed up everything, I know it. You should just stay there. I don't want to risk you getting hurt because of me. You were gonna risk it for me. Yeah, that's true, I guess. No guessing necessary. I didn't realize how brave you were being. Thank you. It means a lot. But, no buts. Except yours, which I'm saving. Are you sure? Extremely. Oh. I'll be there in a flash. Excellent. Wait, we? Here we go. Duh. Hey, we're here. Oh, geez, is that you under the rubble? I mean, I assume it is. I hope so. Not that I want you to be getting crushed under rubble. I hope it didn't happen enough that I'd mistake you for someone else being crushed under rubble. No, it's me. I was lucky. Lucky? Left for dead, covered up, but not hurt badly enough to actually die. The ones who got culled on sight, or snatched up to be culled later, probably in some sick, high blood spectacle, they weren't as lucky as me. Is this what you're rebelling against? These drone things? No, I mean, not really. The heir is in charge, and the drones obey her. It is her birthright. So why is she doing this? I have no idea. Low bloods get cold for anything and every reason. For anything and everything, or no reason at all. She doesn't have to have one. Or maybe our sub-grub being on fire means we makes... Maybe our sub-grub... Being on fire makes a really sick selfie background. Are you serious? She sounds terrible. Yeah, no kidding. Sorry, that's up on the thing. It's like Tetrarch says, the slow, the soft, the unlucky, the troublemakers. Anyone who doesn't jump when the heiress snaps her webby little fingers, they get rounded up, enslaved, or slaughtered. Especially rest buds, like me. This is terrible. Your neighborhood is on fire. You're buried in rubble. Like you said, this is why we were rebelling. This is so awful. Why hasn't someone already put a stop to this? My subgrub is full of lowbuds. We don't matter. So nobody who does matter cares. All this is taking out the garbage. It's always been this way. Nobody does anything about it, especially not gutterbloods. Like me, they were mostly good at lying down to die. But you're rebelling, right? So you are doing something. Oh, that's not me, that's the Tetrarch. Tetrarch Damick is different. He's amazing. I wish you could meet him. He always does things like he's in a movie where he's the star, you know? He put the whole thing together. The Rebel Network, the plan, the Rebel, not the Rebel. I am having trouble reading tonight. Probably because of all the studying and the testing. The Rebel Network, the plan, all of it. But without him, we don't have a chance. He was the one everyone talked to, and now he's gone. He's gone and I'm alone. And I'm slow and I'm soft and I'm stupid. I'm just a nothing little gutter blood nobody. Okay, I've got to pick the correct no. So I'm gonna do big no. What? This damn it guy, he sounds like he stinks. What? Okay, I'm sorry, but you talk about him constantly, and not a single word you've said makes him sound like... That's weirdly worded. Okay, I'm sorry, but you talk about him constantly, and not a single word you've said doesn't make him sound like an awful bully. Those are, like, multiple negatives that could have cleaned that up a little bit. No! It's not like that at all. He's just looking out for me. Oh, open your eyes. Why do you think you're really saying these terrible things? It's not like I don't know where you're coming from. Sometimes my paw makes me feel just rotten. And I think, am I the reason he's never around? What's wrong with me that makes my own father not want to see me? But that's a load of garbage. The only person responsible for the terrible things he does is him. You don't understand. Me and the Tetrarch had been together since we were grubs. We were fated to be Morales. Morales? You wouldn't get it because you're an alien. I need him. No, you don't. I may not know anything about the social customs of this crazy alien planet, but I know that a real friend would never stand by and let you think and say those things about yourself. I don't think you're nothing. In fact, I know you're not nothing. You've got plenty of your own bravery. Just because fighting back was his idea... I don't know why I've got a case of the odds today. I've tried to stifle him, but it just makes me make funny faces, funnier than normal. Just because fighting back was his idea doesn't mean it didn't take courage to see it through. And you were going to risk everything to save me, an alien you'd never even met. Come on. Here's my fluffy deer cat. Sit down, please. He's like, I want to just lay on this one leg. They got spotted today. That's the bravest thing I've heard. That's the bravest thing I've heard get tried. This is weird wording. Do you really think so? Yeah. I believe in you, Zephyros. Wow, you remembered my name this time. Yes. Because you made such a big impression on me and were such good friends. It'd be really sad if you gave up and died here under these rocks. Oh man, that actually means a lot to me. I'd never dream that something like this could happen for someone like me. Zephyros, I'm going to do my absolute best to raise your standard of friendship to the point where having your name remembered is not the nicest thing anyone has ever done for you. I'm not alone after all. I've got Joey Alien here to save me. And tell me what to do. Well, no. We're in this together. Oh yeah, right. Thanks, Joey. Let's get you out of there and then figure out what's next. Are you sure you don't know anyone who can help us? I kind of don't even know what kind of help we need, but it seems we do. Well, I do know someone. But they don't actually live nearby. It'll be a journey. Are you sure they'll help us? Another yawn. Oh yeah, she hates the Eris. She's our biggest fan. Remember, they have a boy band. That's good enough for me. Now hold still. I'm going to get you out of there. I have to use this on him, I believe. Boink. So I would expect a hoverboard to be used for hovering, but apparently it also has a laser that moves things. So do we take... Oh. Oh. embarrassed. Here we go. Did we leave his behind? His Lucis behind? Oh. Well, that's a good picture. That's pretty. I do like the color scheme of... what is that? I don't remember. Oh, that's right, it's her ship. So this is like the queen lady. It's the selfie that they called. I think that's the end, pretty much. Kansas City Shuffle. Look at the dog! I really want to pet that dog. Based on Homestuck. Written by Andrew Hussey and Cohen Edenfield. If I remember right, there were some names I recognized. I think. My brain is overheating trying to think. But some of these pictures are really cute. Lead animator. Environmental art. I like that picture a lot. Lead composer, James Roach. I thought that Toby Fox was involved in, like, the music, but I guess not. Oh, yeah, Temmie Chang at the bottom of animation, bottom right. It says Temmie Chang. She was involved with Undertale. Maybe that's what I was thinking. I was thinking that there was something from Undertale in here, but maybe that was what I was thinking. I could have sworn, though, that he had something to do with the music. Oh, no, he did. Just James Roach and Toby Fox. So Toby Fox helped do the music for this, too. So he's the one who made Undertale and Deltarune. Maybe someday I'll play Undertale for funsies in, like, on a stream or something, but that's not in the plan right now, but maybe. And then... I'll probably do a full run through Deltarune starting from episode 1 when the third installment comes out. I don't know when it's supposed to come out, but I don't want to do it so close because it was the first thing that I streamed like a month ago or whatever was Deltarune chapter 2. So I don't want to like redo them too quickly. So alright, but that was Hiveswap. I hope that you enjoyed this little, it's not even an hour, it was 30, looks like 38 minutes, so I hope you enjoyed this little finish to our Hiveswap game, and I will see you on Sunday at 8 Central for a very large chunk of Night in the Woods, because that's my favorite. I'm so excited to see you guys there. I am so excited to do silly voices for you. I hope you have a wonderful, what is today? Thursday. I hope you have a wonderful Thursday, and I will see you on Sunday.